Hi, this is Dr. Susan Riegg from SusanRiegMD.com, and in this short video I'd like to give just a brief overview of bioidentical hormones, what they are, how we test for them, and how we treat imbalances that occur. So hormones should really exist in harmony with each other. There's no hormone that acts by itself, and every single hormone in the body interacts with other hormones. So we really are looking at the entire endocrine system because hormone imbalances can affect any of these organs. So we're talking about the hypothalamus, the pituitary gland, thyroid gland, adrenals, ovaries, testes, and of course the pancreas producing insulin. We're going to have a particular focus on thyroid, adrenal, and sex hormones from gonads. And it turns out that all of these are controlled by the pituitary gland, which secretes prohormones that circulate in the body and then arrive at the end organ and stimulate it to produce its final hormonal effect. There is one form of bioidentical hormone balancing that everyone is familiar with, and that is replacing deficient insulin in patients who are insulin-dependent diabetics. And the principles of this are very, very similar to testing and restoring estrogen, progesterone, testosterone, and thyroid hormones. There are a whole host of symptoms involved with hormonal imbalances. Some are very similar between men and women, but there are some unique symptoms that are specific to each gender. For women, the primary symptoms include weight gain, mood swings, hot flashes and night sweats, tender breasts, loss of sex drive or libido, and then interestingly, many women have extreme fatigue during the day and then insomnia and problems sleeping at night. Men can have similar symptoms, but they are more commonly describing things like a burned out feeling, decreased mental clarity and memory, also decrease in sex drive, irritability, depression, erectile dysfunction, and other symptoms. It turns out that the root cause of many hormone imbalances is effect of chronic stress. And it's really difficult to describe why this is without showing you just a little bit of biochemistry. I won't go too deep, but I just want to demonstrate the effect of chronic stress on sex hormones and on thyroid hormones. You can see in this diagram, we're seeing all the steroid hormones which are being produced in a cascade. The beginning of this pathway starts with cholesterol, and then the pathway can go in two different directions. We can go in this direction to make sex hormones, which is primarily estrogen and testosterone, or the second pathway, which takes us to cortisol, which is stress hormone. Now, I'm sure you can appreciate that if there is a great deal of chronic stress, whether it be psychological stress or physiologic stressors, the pathway going to produce cortisol is going to be dominant, and it's going to pull away the precursors, take them away from production of sex hormones. So this illustrates how elevated chronic stress actually decreases your production of sex hormones. In a different mechanism, elevated stress takes away from thyroid function, and specifically, it affects thyroid in a way that does not show up on the TSH test. So when stress is greatly elevated, the hypothalamus is communicating with the pituitary and the pituitary communicating with the adrenal to produce cortisol. Now there's a number of instances here where the stress response is dominant over the thyroid and it crosses over and can inhibit production of different thyroid hormones. So for example, corticotropin releasing hormone can inhibit production of TSH. Also, when cortisol is being produced abnormally, as in chronic stress, it will also inhibit production of TSH and it will inhibit conversion of T4 hormone to T3 hormone. And T3 is really the hormone that we need for our metabolic processes. That's the active thyroid hormone. In addition, what's not shown here is that if cortisol is too low, it will inhibit proper interaction of T3 and the T3 receptor on the cell. So the main point being, a couple of points actually, first of all, elevated stress causes significant disruption of thyroid hormones. And secondly, I we'll talk more about this in a future video, but TSH test is a screening test. It stands for thyroid stimulating hormone. And it is specific but not sensitive. And all that means is that if TSH is normal or even low, that does not mean that you have normal thyroid function, because it can be suppressed by all of these other problems. So TSH test is not a reliable test. And if you have all of the symptoms of hypothyroidism, you should really consider checking much more than a TSH test. You should be checking your T4 level, free T3 level, and also thyroid peroxidase autoantibody. So the point of all of this is that hormones need to be balanced. All of these hormones are affecting each other, and if there's an imbalance in one, it will affect other hormones in the body and cause significant symptoms. As far as testing hormones, what we typically do is a saliva test for the sex hormones and for cortisol. And we will do all of the other testing on blood, either a blood spot, which is shown here, where we get a little finger poke and get drops of blood on a piece of filter paper, or we will do a venous blood draw. That has the advantage of being able to do some other lab tests, including a complete blood count or a CBC, and also doing a metabolic panel and some other tests. After we have results, then we'll put together a protocol for the patient that includes bioidentical hormones. And in the case of sex hormones, those are usually administered with a cream so that the hormones are delivered transdermally or through the skin. And with thyroid or any other hormones, that can often be an oral compounded capsule. Now, the types of hormones that we're talking about are typically not manufactured by pharmaceutical companies, and there's a lot of reasons for that, mainly because these compounds occur in nature and cannot be patented, so there is really not a very good profit margin on them. So what we do is write prescriptions and recommend that they be filled at compounding pharmacies. And these are a little bit different than a traditional pharmacy. They have specifically trained pharmacists that know exactly how to compound these formulations as prescribed exactly for each individual patient. There are numerous benefits to bioidentical hormone balancing. I won't read all of these off, but suffice it to say that not only are we trying to reduce symptoms, but even in a case where a patient is completely asymptomatic, we're definitely reducing risk for breast cancer and other proliferative diseases of the breast or endometrium. And it's very well known that hormone deficiencies increase risk for osteopenia, osteoporosis, and fracture. And so we really want to protect bone and make sure all of the sex hormones are in adequate quantities so that we're not running a risk of losing a lot of bone as we get older, which will result in fracture and other morbidity. So if you need help, you should call or email me today. My phone number is 414-395-4622. Or if you're out of state, our toll-free number, 1-800-210-1107. And of course, we have a contact form on the website, so you can always shoot me an email. Just put your email and your comments, and as soon as I possibly can, I will get back to you.